Chelsea, you're blushing.
Am I? I'm excited to see him. I mean, yeah. I just didn't know why we cut off communication.
We didn't cut. Last time I saw you, we had dinner together in Melbourne because she... Whoa.
With his wife.
My wife was there.
Yeah,
his wife was there. Sorry. They were getting along a little too well for my liking.
Yeah, it was almost too much, yeah.
But she did that thing, you know, people always talk about, they're going to come to Australia. Americans always say, I always want to go there. She came and we actually went out and had dinner and stuff. So it was fun.
What he didn't know is I actually went all the way to Australia just to have dinner with him. Obviously, I didn't want to front-load that information.
Yeah, you're like, hey, how's it going? Good morning. How you doing, Eric? What were you doing in Australia? Were you doing the show?
I was doing stand-up. I was on a tour. So he came out with me. But then I emailed you about the documentary because we were going to use you at the end, and I wanted him to make a video of himself explaining why he would never marry a girl like me. And he said he was sick or had the Zika virus
sick
or something.
No, he did not say that. The first time in about 2 years that I've been that sick was the time that you wanted me to do a video, and I thought, I'll just bring the tone of the show down. I felt terrible. No. But you still put me in.
I did. I thought you would be, that's a huge compliment to you, right? Nobody else has a crush on you like I do.
No, just you and my wife. Thank you.
No, because I think everyone has a crush on Eric Bannon, because here's why. Guys as well, because you watch you and you're this tough guy and you're a good actor, but then you realize if you research you or read up on you that you're a comedian. You have a comedic background. You're very funny.
That was my background. That was my... Any Australians here?
Yeah. So half our audience are Australians. Yeah, we're... That's
they'll
right.
vouch for me. That was my background back home before I started being very serious, was, you know, stand-up and, like yourself, sketch comedy. I mean, I was on a show called Full Frontal, which was very similar to Saturday Night Live, actually. So it was
Does
just all...
Does that show your penis?
No.
It was family hours.
But it was like Saturday Night Live?
Yeah, it was similar to Saturday Night Live. It was just all sketch-based, and we would do pre-record during the week, and then Friday nights would get an audience in, and I'd always get into trouble for laughing, and...
You would laugh in the middle of sketches?
I was a shocker. I was a shocker. I heard you were really bad, too. No,
that's not true. My show didn't air in Australia. I would laugh all the time. Yeah. I felt bad. I didn't want to laugh, but it was just so funny. These people were out of my league. I was acting with people like Will Ferrell and Molly Shannon. These people were just on a different planet.
It was the best feeling in the world when you cannot control yourself.
Yeah.
And you can't be laughing, and you just can't get it together. And sometimes you urinate. You know what I mean? I mean, that's a spectacular feeling.
It really is. And they would know that I'm an easy laugh, so they would actually purposely like do stuff just to try to make me break during sketches.
The thing that used to get me was head turns. Head turns were the worst. So if you like, you start a sketch and you go like that. Every time, it's like the minute someone turns their head towards me, I'd be gone.
I'd lose it. Yeah.
I once got ripped by my ear by the director and escorted out of the studio like a 5-year-old because there was a co-star that I would always laugh at. Rima, her name was, and we would quite often do sketches together. And it got so bad, we got separated and we have to do split screen. So I would do pre-recorded sketches to like someone from the crew who would just sit there like this.
Yeah. You know,
and then they'd get me out and they'd put her in and they'd cut it together.
Yes.